We'll begin our exploration into methods for generating fractals by looking again at the Koch curve. We'll see that a few simple modifications to the process that generates the Koch curve yield fractals that are much more interesting and much more realistic in many ways. Throughout this unit, I'll make use of several online programs that can be found at different websites, and links to all of the programs that I refer to in these videos, as well as a few others, can be found in a subunit towards the end of this one called Computer Programs. So all the links that you need should be there. All right, let's get started with a Koch curve. So here's the Koch curve. Recall that to generate it, what one does is replace a line segment with a bent line segment at every step. So in other words, this is the basic operation. We take a line segment and we turn it into that, and we repeat this process. So this is the basic process, the sort of generating step for this fractal. So we might start with a line segment like this. So n equals 0, that would be in black. And then the next step would be to replace this line segment with a bent line segment. So the blue curve, that's n equals 1. Now I have 1, 2, 3, 4 line segments. In the Koch curve, these should all be the same length. This is obviously not a perfect drawing. Step n equal 2, I replace each blue segment by a bent segment. So that becomes So that's n equals 2. And then I could repeat that one more time. There are, let's see, 16 of these segments. Each of those 16 line segments gets replaced with a bent segment. All right, so there is step n equals 3. And one could do a few more steps, but one would quickly run out of patience. So this is not the most beautiful drawing. I'm clearly not an artist. It does give the idea, though. But if we want to experiment with this, go to larger n's and see what happens if we tried slightly different rules over here, we're going to need a computer to make some pictures for us. So what I'll do next is show you a website that will let you make Koch curves like this, and lots of other cool things. So this is a program that will let you draw Koch curves and variations thereof. So let me show you how it works, and then we'll start experimenting a little bit, and then you can experiment some as well. So first, let's go down here, and I'm going to make sure that Snap to Grid is chosen. And what that'll do is, as I move these red points around, it'll make them go to points on the grid. There's a very faint grid in gray. It might be hard to see on the screen, but I can make the point sort of stick there. So I'm going to move these points around till we have something like this. So what I've done is I've created that shape, that sort of that generator, that bent line shape that's at the core of the Koch curve construction. And then I can change the iterations, go from n equals 0 to 1 to 2 like before. So I usually start with n equals 1 so I can see what that first step is. I go down an iteration. Well, we start with a straight line. The first step is to take the straight line, replace it with a bent line. Then we have four lines. We replace each of those with a bent line. And then we replace each of those with a bent line. and so on. And we have a nice Koch curve that the program generates for us. Certainly much nicer than that one I just drew by hand. Let's go down maybe a few iterations. If you wanted to see the original step, you could click on view also the zeroth iteration. Then it makes this yellow line down here. I don't find that very helpful, but sometimes it's nice to see what the first iteration was, because that's the basic geometric transformation that gets repeated again and again and again. So I like kind of keeping that on sometimes so I can see. So it reminds me that I'm taking a straight line and turning it into a bent line, this thing in blue. And then we can iterate that again and again and again. So now I have a tool that will make Koch curves for us. And I'll show you in the next video that it can do lots more as well.